Hey everyone, it's Jen with Ink Insomniac. I'm taking part in the April Pouring Challenge, which has suggested that you use only four colors, white, magenta, turquoise, and orange. So I do have my colors here. I have most of them pre-mixed from an earlier pour. I'm going to add to them as well. So when I do my pours, I use one part paint to two parts Floetrol, and then some water depending on the consistency I want. Usually like honey, like kind of stringy, maybe almost like a thin icing. Sometimes I add silicone to the cup. Sometimes I add silicone to the actual pouring cup. This time, I'm going to add the silicone to the pour cups, I believe, because I'm gonna do two different things. I'm gonna try to do a butterfly, and then either a blow or a swipe background. We'll see how it goes. One thing about pouring is you usually will change up your strategy at any given time if it doesn't work out the way you want it to. I hope you subscribe to my channel, and if you have any comments or suggestions, I welcome them in the section below. Thank you very much for watching, and let's get started. Okay, so I've learned to eye stuff here. So, put just a little more in there, like that. It's very thick. The Winsor & Newton paints are extremely thick for me. And oh my gosh, I'm going through Floetrol like crazy. Two parts Floetrol. About there. I don't know if you can see that, but It comes to about like right here on the cup after I've added, because I already had about, I don't know, maybe about an inch in the cup already. And water. Start off with a splash. And then I stir it up real quick just to see what I'm working with. If you give the cup a pinch on the side while you're stirring, you can wipe your popsicle stick almost clean. It's still kind of clumpy, so that is really, well, except for the clumps, I just got to keep stirring a little bit, but pretty much as the consistency I'm going for. Like I said, I did a previous pour in this cup, so you really want to make sure that anything you had is totally blended. If not, it'll leave puddles on your canvas. Okay. Magenta's done. For a 16 by 20 inch panel, 11 ounces of paint is the best coverage, or is the amount needed to fully cover your canvas without any problems. Alright, turquoise. That is perfect, but I need more turquoise. So, yeah, metallic cobalt blue, which is still turquoise. Add just a little bit more. Just a little bit. I love metallic. It just brings out, it really brings is not a difference in your paintings. Whoa. Try to just stir it. If you whip it or really stir it hard, it makes air bubbles and they will pocket on your canvas. I won everything yesterday, so sometimes I tend to go a little too fast, and I've kind of learned my lesson. Thick. What a stringy texture. When you add water for the first couple stirs, it gets extremely watery. So it can kind of be deceiving sometimes that you've made it too watery. But just give it a few more, you know, a few more stirs and spend another minute or two mixing it gently, and you'll realize that it really wasn't. Now that might be just a tad bit too watery for me. No, well, I don't know. We're gonna add just a little more paint. I try to go sparing with this because this is my favorite color and I use it just about it. Whoa! Anyway. No worries. I'm not worried about that. Because this is actually not gessoed. The one that I am using is already gessoed, but it's a cover-up of a mess-up that I had. Well, there really is no such thing as mess-ups in art, but I didn't care for it too much, so time to cover it up and move on to bigger and better things. I need to pick it up to stir this. I don't know if it's still on camera or not. Sorry for all the sniffles. They cut all our grass out here today, and I'm not allergic to it, but it's definitely affecting me. Alright, I think that's what I want. So, there's my, well, I got a couple clumps still. That's the consistency that I was telling you about. And my happy color, orange. Nope. Need more Floetrol. Enough for now. What a great product, by the way. actually, that is really perfect. But I want a deep orange, so mix some magenta to it. That didn't work out too well. No matter. See it changing. The pigment from the Floetrol wasn't allowing it to get any darker. There is no pigment in Floetrol, but all the Floetrol in the magenta, it wasn't enough. I'm right where I want it. Water. See, I guess all clumpy for a second. And it comes right back. Perfect. See, I kind of like stir from the bottom, like I have my, that way it's not really creating air bubbles. Okay. All right. There needs to be more in there. Water. Some people say water, and some people say water. And I'm just making a mess here. I should have moved my canvas, but it'll be alright. Definitely using a canvas that I really don't care about. I am kind of in uncharted waters here. Oh, wait a minute. I'm glad I stopped for a second. Where did it go? Excellent. Okay. is my white scraper. This is my favorite tool. Just a regular old piece of cardboard. Spread it so nice and even. And I keep using it. And it just doesn't. It never lets me down. Perfect. All right. Is fine for me. I'll sit that over here. Keep telling myself, get gloves on before you do this, and every time, never fails. Use my measuring cup. I just said we gotta get to right about there. Just give it like a little fold. If you stir it too much, you're going to have little cells. We want big ones. And then that's the dimethicone. This is silicone. And I will put this in the bore cup. Normally I'll use alcohol, but today going to use these. So, okay. Let's start off with some white. Criss cross. We'll see how that goes. That looks so pretty. I just want to leave it just the way it is. But no, we're going to play with it. We're going to send it this way. And then, whoop, bring it back. I don't know how well this is going to go over here in the corner. So we'll try. Oh, I don't want to lose my center. Even though it's already going. I just have to leave the corners out. It almost looks like a geode. I'm gonna stop. I like it just the way it is. Yep. I think I got some great cells going on. This is always the daunting task of an acrylic pour, is when to cease, when to stop. It's just so pretty. Oh man, that's awesome. Yep, we're gonna just stop right where it is. And there you have it. Unfortunately, I'm out of the April challenge because I am just extremely happy with this. And I cannot bring myself to do anything else. Anyway, I always welcome your comments and suggestions below. You are more than welcome to contact me. I have my Instagram page, Ink Insomniac, at Instagram. I'm starting my YouTube channel. It hasn't it's been created, but it's not officially online yet. But I do have my website, which is inkinsomniac.com, and I'm starting to display my stuff there. I have all of my paintings so far on Instagram. Well, all my pours, not all my paintings, but all the pours. And, yeah. Excellent. I am just so happy with this. Cover up my sides here. I got these little bottles at Dollar General. They were $1.50 for two of them, which was kind of steep, but I really needed to squeeze a bottle quick, so. Yep, that's what I went with. I can't really see over here if I got everything or not. I hope I did. Voila. It's always good to walk around your painting because you can see what you missed, if anything. Even the bottom of the cup is pretty. I think it's time to get into some jewelry. All right. Once again, thank you for watching and have a good night.